to do a thought experiment. Now, I know this is going to scare some people. Probably a few people. I mean, I can think of a few people it's definitely going to scare. Other people are probably going to, you know, hope that I actually take, you know, go through with it. I would like to know. Well, first of all, I want to give a disclaimer. I'm not going to kill myself. I'm not going to harm myself. I'm not going to do anything like that. If I genuinely actually feel like that, I will immediately seek help. But as far as the thought experiment, why shouldn't I kill myself? And, you know, the logical reasons as to why I should or should not. Now here's my argument for as to why I should. I'm a 40-year-old middle-aged man. I'm a felon. I have no real successes under my belt. I'm incredibly ugly. I'm a felon. I'm a virgin. I have no prospects whatsoever. I'm a parasite upon society. I mean, like the burger that I bought, right? You know, what person, whose taxes paid for me to eat a fucking burger? I mean, that's basically stealing. It's all it is stealing. I'm a thief. Now, you know, I'm sure some people could make arguments against why I shouldn't kill myself. But I mean, I would like legitimate arguments. Not, well, because then we won't have anyone to laugh at. That's not what's in it. And also, as far as the consistency of arguments, you can make the argument that you should not kill yourself just because you're ugly, because there's a lot of people who are ugly. And there's a lot of people who are a lot uglier than you, and they're so happy. Also, there's a lot of people being parasites off the taxpayers, not just you. And you're not the worst of it. I mean, yeah, you might get $10,000 a year, but there's pensioners who, after all is said and done, they're getting $100,000 a year. And they're retiring at 50, they're going to die at 90. So for 30 or 40 years, they're going to get $100,000 free money. And I find it fascinating that the people screaming about me getting breadcrumbs from the state don't want to even mention the people who work for the state. Well, I know one of them, at least one of them, has a state job, works for the government. So yeah, he's looking at retirement at 50, 55, and then a nice juicy pension. I mean, I can definitely make the argument that the young are getting screwed over because the state sacrifices the young to pay for the pensions and the votes of the old. probably one of the reasons why the young aren't having children. They're like, fuck this. Fuck this shit. Now, I know if I were to kill myself, there are two things would happen. As far as in regards to me. I would either the atheists are right and there's nothing, it's just the end of consciousness, in which all this would be over, all the pain, all the suffering, all the annoyance, all the irritation, just done. Or I know, because I am virtuous, because I am ethical, I would move on in life. I'd move on. I'd move on. To a better world, to a better universe, to a better existence. I mean, I've had dreams where it's not even that far from now. I've had dreams where I'm like, this like little 5-year-old girl, and I'm bitching about my books, and I'm saying to the adults around me, I'm like, you know, give me my fucking books. And they're like, those books aren't for little girls. And I'm like, I'm not a little girl. And one of them says, well, then what are you? And they're all laughing, and I can tell I'm related to them. I mean, I do believe in reincarnation. And the problem, though, with reincarnation is that you don't know if you're going into a worse situation or a better situation. And, you know, like the Knights Templar, in their religious system, there's the spirit and the soul. The spirit is your personality, it's your likes, dislikes, it's everything that you are in this current lifetime, whereas your soul is separate. It's like your soul is an actor, right? And your soul says, okay, I'm gonna be in this play or in this movie, and I'm gonna play this person in this movie. After the movie, the character is no more. The actor continues doing other films, right? Like Johnny Depp or Keanu Reeves or somebody like that, right? Or Brad Pitt, right? And then you'd have to question, do they fit the archetype? Because certain actors fit certain archetypes. And, you know, Gal Gadot, for example, is always going to be Wonder Woman. Christopher Reeves is always going to be Superman, even though he's gone. Adolf Hitler is always going to be the nasty little shit who fucks everything up. Same with Hillary Clinton, Bill Clinton, Donald Trump, all these people, right? Stephen Molyneux is always going to be the philosopher. There's different archetypes, and see, it fascinates me that people don't understand just basic fucking Jungian psychology. I'd like to be in a situation where I can just make videos all fucking day and not worry about anything else. Just apply what I know out of the books into real life. Write scripts, write books, write all this shit. I can't do that here. I mean, even after in the middle of fucking nowhere, pretty much, I'm still drawn to LA. I'm like, part of me's like, take that 3-hour bus ride, go to fucking Hollywood Boulevard, go to the beach, go, just do everything you can, drink up every drop of life. Because every time I feel like shit. I feel like an absolute piece of shit. And with my medical issues and all this other stuff, it frustrates me, it really frustrates me. Because, I mean, it's like, I go back to Nebraska, and I know I'm going to be just as bored, just as miserable as I am here. Well, I mean, what I'm going to do is I'm going to get a couple of hypoallergenic cats, most likely. But that's a long term. Those things are expensive, and that's a long term commitment. And I know somebody in the comments from one of my other videos did say, you know, maybe just wait. Wait a while and see if your hook comes into, you know, as far as acting. I understand that. And oh, and also, I want to say a fuck you to Happy Jesus 123, also known as Telly Sorensen, over there in Canada. I owe nothing to anybody. I don't owe restitution. The judge actually signed a paper saying that I don't owe restitution. Because he looked at my economic record. He said, well, the guy's homeless. He has no money. He has no money. He has nothing. It's wiped out. It's gone. I mean, I thank God every fucking day that I didn't steal any money from somebody alive. Fuck. The dead don't care. They don't need their property. If I die, my property is, you know, either thrown away or sold or whatever. I mean, just, shy of fucking character. Shit bothers me. I think to a certain degree, you have to shut that off in order to succeed. You have to treat it like business. But what I did was not business, it was theft. And even though, oh, and another thing I'm gonna complain about is that somebody sits there and babbles about, you know, me taking real estate classes that and dad have given them. Fuck you. Fuck you. This is because, number one, I did learn a lot. I learned a lot of what I didn't already know. I realized how much I needed to learn. Real estate can't be lucrative. Part of the problem with California is that there is so much competition and the prices are so high. If I went, say I went to Kansas or Ohio or Oklahoma, and did the house real estate thing there, flipping thing there, right? Adverse possession. And there's lots of adverse, there's lots of houses in the middle of fucking nowhere that I could do adverse possession with in fucking Kansas or Ohio or Nebraska or Illinois or wherever. I mean, it would suck to be in the winter, but only to a certain degree. I mean, I have no problem sitting inside for, you know, 4 or 5 months out of the year during the winter. That's not a problem. Especially if I'm making money through writing or videos or something like that. So part of my problem is that I don't trust myself enough to do what I need to do. Instead, I trust others, and that's because I was taught. As a little kid, everybody else has the answer. Everybody else knows what they're doing. Everybody else got the script. Oh, and I love these fucking subtle photoshops on the Corky front. Look, guys, if you're gonna photoshop me, do it right. Don't make one eye bigger and the nose a little more bulbous. Go all out. Make me look like a fucking monster. Do both eyes. Make me look like some kind of, like, hideous creation that's gonna come out from under the bed and eat you alive at 3 in the morning while you're desperately trying to, you know, get your bearings in the dark. I'm really tired of being laughed at. But I mean, even as a little kid, I was laughed at. Even as a little kid. Even as a little kid. It was just like, it was fucking pure hell. Nobody would play with me. Nobody would talk to me. Girls just, no matter how nice or successful I was, wanted absolutely nothing to do with me. It sucks. You know, there's something. It's kind of fucked up when you meet a woman who is as ugly as you are, and you say, "Hey, would you like to go get a coffee sometime?" And her response is to act embarrassed, and then the next day come at you with a fucking knife. I don't understand it either. Apparently it's magic. Magic. That's taxpayer. I stole this from some taxpayer. Fucking stole it from a taxpayer. What the government doesn't tell you is that they have two lists, right? Two lists. Yeah, a list of all the taxpayers. Their names, their social security numbers, their addresses, everything. Then they have all the list of all the government parasites, including the bureaucrats. Oh, but if you work for the government, you're not a parasite. Oh, shut up. So, once you're on that list, right? It's actually a third list. The third list basically tells you tell shit. Which taxpayer is paying their tax money to which parasite? You know. Also, I don't know what certain people in Canada, certain viewers of mine in Canada or Sweden or whatever are complaining about, because I'm not feeding off their taxes. Whose specific taxes? Actually, I think I know. Because the person whose taxes for paying, the person whose federal taxes paying for my money was somebody by the name of Eleanor Murphy. Interesting. You should investigate. It's just that now. You know whose taxes are paying for me now? Somebody will flip out at this. No, it's not Alfonso. Fuck that. No. Wishful thinking, but no. Melissa Benoit. She's a famous actress. Well, semi-famous, she's on the CW. Her taxes are going to pay for my lifestyle. So, you know what I'm thinking? I'm thinking she should be informed of this. And then, as an act of vengeance against my parasite ways, I know that gross job. Good. As revenge for my parasite ways, she should be notified. And then she should show up at my door in her Supergirl costume and beat me up. Because, you know, I know she's much more of a man than Timmy is. Timmy tried, couldn't do it. Also, I wasn't going to defend myself because I'm a fella. I wouldn't want the cops running up and, you know, trying to figure out who did what. And then, oh, you're a felon, Mr. Bravo. Obviously, you're to blame. Melissa Benoit. just show up to my door. My Supergirl costume totally fucking beat me up. That would be justice. I know Happy Jesus will say, what if it's Eleanor Murphy's ghost in a Supergirl costume? That's one reason we know Happy Jesus 123 should not be allowed to wander around in public on his own. I'm going to get the nose job. La la la. I'm getting way too fat. He's crazy. It's crazy, Corky. I wonder if Timmy will lie to his lawyer the same way he lied to the last lawyer. Be good to know. Maybe I should find out who his lawyer is and put him in touch with him. So that lawyer can tell. Well, his lawyer will find out. Because his lawyer will look at all the evidence and they'll say, wait a minute. Tim's full of shit. I can tell there's a booger up there. That's disgusting. Sorry about that. I'm not sure what that was. I don't think it was a burger. And I'm sure there's probably some people who are going to sit down like this and think, how can I use this against Corky? How can I use it against Corky? Maybe Corky's crazy. Maybe Corky needs to leave LA for the sake of his sanity and be left the hell alone by the fucking government. That's a definite possibility. We should look into that. Also, a job is gonna solve my problems no more than getting a nose job. I mean, if I won the lottery, that solves just as many jobs, it solves just as many problems as I have now as with getting a job. Solve them faster. So it's stealing another house. Maybe. Maybe. People should sit there and ask themselves why their predatory nature is enlivened by my presence. I think that's a very important question for them to ask themselves. What about me makes them feel that they have the right to hurt me? I went on a flight to talk to my parole officer yesterday, or Friday. He said, you know, if anybody attacks me, I have the right to defend myself. I have the right to defend myself, and I should. No matter what. So if I'm in fear of my life, if I'm in fear of my life, I'm gonna be asking, are you truly in fear of your life? Yeah. Because, I mean, here in LA, I mean, there's people who will kill a person for fucking $5. So, knowing how much certain people prize their reputation, yeah, I think a lot of people, I mean, you know, people are perfectly willing to sacrifice my life for $100,000. So, to protect their own ass, yeah, I think people are, I mean, I'd love to be able to give people the benefit of the doubt, but I've seen too much. I've seen too many people who are just absolutely fucking willing to destroy another person's life for the sake of a few crumbs. Sad, but it happens. So, but now, find a job, get a car. I don't have a good track record of jobs. I mean, here's the thing. I don't like myself be treated like shit by employers or by my coworkers. I've literally lost jobs because I remember I had one job at McDonald's and I had the supervisor. He was screaming, cussing. He was just every fucking name in the book. I sat there and I looked him in the eye and I said, "You don't get to speak to me that way. Don't do it again." He fired me. Oh well. Yeah, I don't tolerate that bullshit. I don't tolerate it. Yeah. You want to scream and cuss me out, I better be getting something out of it. You know, an extra couple $100 in my pocket? Yeah, I'll consider it. Some great sex by a beautiful woman? No, I'll consider it. I mean, there's a lot that I would do. You know, because it's like, okay, well, if you want to treat me this way, you know, you're going to pay the price. Just like Timmy right now is paying the price for treating me like shit. For treating me like some subhuman piece of garbage that didn't deserve anything more than to be sacrificed to somebody's own incompetence and greed. And I can promise, I promise, that I will do everything I can to ensure the expedition of karma. You know, one nice thing about getting a farmhouse out in like the Midwest or something would be I'd be able to do characters. I would like to do the elitist character. I would like to come up with the biggest shit nonsense possible. I've got like a whole bunch of shit that I'm gonna use against the SJWs. As far as like for example, do you know that the fear of ugly people is called something like cacophobia or something like that. The fear of ugly people. So I could make the claim. That if Lacey Green does not sleep with me, she's cacophobic and thus being a bigot. And that's basically how I could spin it. I could say a lot of you people want me to be a fucking clown, well then I gotta have fucking equipment and situation in which I can be a fucking clown. Because this being in sober living, this being in shit like this, counting the days till I can get the fuck out, be done with this shit. Timmy says innocent, I'll have to stay for the trial. After that, I'm fucking gone. Because I'm done putting up with this abuse. Done putting up with the abuse, and now I'm not gonna fucking kill myself. You know, I remember seeing an Al Bundy episode, Married with Children, and it guest starred Bobcat Goldthwait, and it was a spoof of Miracle on 34th Street, right? And it was like Al Bundy had the option of basically, he could choose to have never been born, and his soul would like reside in heaven and he'd be happy. And he was just like, no, fuck you, these people have caused me so much pain, fuck them. Edward O'Neill, I honest to God, that's him and Bryan Cranston are really the only two celebrities that I would actually get like fucking weak in the knees for. I'd be like, this is so fucking awesome. Brad Pitt, whatever. Also, that fucking CW Supergirl show. If you're a comic book fan, you'll know how and why they fucked up the Mixaplik character completely. I would have been the perfect Mixaplik. I really would have. You'll know why if you've ever read the comic. So that said. I'm gonna end this video now, so I can go do other stuff. Have a day.